You know what? You people are shit. You're hiding behind the
hiding.
You're a bear.
You're the aggressor. Take your watermelon and beat it. Was an inside job. If you don't know that, research building 7. But anyway, we got our huge sign up today. We got Morpheus here, got everybody else here. We're getting thousands of honks. It's crazy. You think 9/11 was an inside job?
Absolutely.
Why? When did you first find out?
Well, I started hearing about it probably a couple of years after it happened. You know, the idea that 9/11 was an inside job.
When the first time you heard about it, did you think they were crazy?
Not necessarily crazy, but highly implausible.
Really? What was the main factor where you said, man, this is kind of fishy?
Oh, I just saw a couple of videos and I thought, yeah, makes sense to me. And then I really started checking it out, going to meetings. And every time I learned more and more about it, it just reinforced my belief that it was an inside job.
Nobody's in charge. Okay. It's all individuals coming together for a common purpose.
We're getting a call from TPS saying that you guys are possibly making people honk, do all that other stuff.
Oh my God!
What happens with that is if there's an accident, they'll list you guys as contributing factors. So I don't know if you guys want that. I don't know if you guys have a permit to be here.
Anybody would like to take that?
I'm sorry?
I'm asking these guys, anybody willing to take responsibility for that?
They're saying if anybody's an accident, we're liable for it.
Anybody can sue anybody similarly.
They would have to prove we're liable.
But here's another thing. Do you guys have a permit to be up here to protest?
Is it public pedestrian walk?
You have to have a permit to assess your First Amendment rights?
Well, that's what DPS is telling us.
We'd be happy to talk to DPS if they want to come out here instead of making you guys do their constitutional
law. Yeah, why do they send you out? Why don't they just come out here?
Because this is our jurisdiction.
But the bridges are theirs, but not this bridge. Okay.
The bridge is ours, so that's
right. The problem is it interferes with the traffic way, and it could be distracting to the drivers.
Yeah, so are billboards, though.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, they got LCD things flashing in your face.
You guys have a hard time, okay?
Yeah.
We get a call, we have to respond, okay? That's all.
Understandable, yeah. And we understand.
Okay.
Cool. We understand.
So, I don't know if you guys want... bring our sergeant down here, and you guys are more than happy to talk to him about this if you guys want to.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay,
that'd be
cool. Well, great, appreciate it.
On his way here, just because this is ours.
DPS is the actual bridge. the regular bridges cars drive over. The bridges are DPSs, but this pedestrian walkway, I'm not for sure, but...
Okay, well, I mean, really, I mean, it's the difference than standing on a public sidewalk, but that really is, you know.
Well, then you got loitering and things like that. Okay. Then you got loitering and things like that. And I'm not saying you guys are doing that, okay? I'm just explaining what could happen, okay? That's all.
Yeah, it's a hypothetical, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, we're not here to give you guys a hard time.
I mean, basically, this is just kind of a friendly...
Absolutely. You know what? Like I said, we get a call here, okay? They're advising us of what's going on and the possible things that can happen, okay? So we're just relaying that to you guys.
Okay.
If you guys don't want to hear that or don't want to...
Oh, we're definitely hearing it.
No, I'm just... Let me finish, okay? Then we'll bring our sergeant out here and he can make a call on what needs to happen, okay?
Right, well, we got... Well, if this is not DPS's jurisdiction, why are they calling it in?
Because they see it coming over the overpass.
Well, I have on video. I have on video. DPS officer said that we could do it. Okay.
Well, then I don't know why they're calling it in, but I'll start to come out here and we can talk to you guys about what's going on.
Okay, cool.
You guys
appreciate
have cards,
it.
By the way?
Yeah, can we?
Anybody has a card?
No.
Until we get it resolved, you just put the sign down. I'm not gonna make you guys. I'm not gonna force you guys off the bridge right now. But I have been on this call before with DPS, and there's a code that falls under as far as because it interferes with the highway.
Do you know the code?
I don't know the code. I can't quote it to you right now.
When your sergeant gets here, he can tell us the code.
We'd be
more than welcome to do that.
I'm not trying to be confrontational at all, sir. I'm just asking a question.
I know it doesn't. It's not kosher always with certain people. I'm sure that's not it, but this is America, and there's going to be things that people don't like and they do like. And if you bring out a statute, which is not even a law anyway, but you bring out a statute, I'm sure they'd listen. But this is protected First Amendment speech. This is a public walkway, and if you can find anything different, like I said, we've already been through this circle before with DPS, and they said it was cool that we could do it as long as we held it up there and there's no danger of it.
You need to take off your zip ties.
Okay, we can do that
because that's affixed to
we can do that
public property.
But ADOT, this is not ADOT's, that's only the bridges. That's an ADOT rule. This is not ADOT. I'm just telling you what I know because I research a lot of it.
As you guys held up the sign, right?
That was on an ADOT bridge.
On an ADOT thoroughfare.
Because it's ADOT's actual bridge.
That's an Arizona Department of Transportation law. This isn't under the ADOT.
See, ADOT. We do a lot of this, and we research the law, and we know it. So it's like, I mean, this is like something you guys don't ever jack around with. It's dumb shit like this, you know? So, but,
we particularly took this one,
it was enclosed. There was no way that the sign could fly out, and we were just trying to make sure that we, they were trying to do everything right.
As civil as possible.
I think their biggest problem was they don't want to have a bunch of accidents, you know, people reading the sign, not paying attention, and things like that.
Yeah, but people do. I mean, they could blame that on any billboard, absolutely. I mean, come on.
Wait, what about someone who's
fancy car?
And they got a car wash sign. I mean,
they're riding doubles, dude.
I'm just wondering how much resource they're dumping into this.
It's a lot, dude.
Seconds. 80,000 tons of steel in the what's up?
And as far as the issue of causing all the honking, you know, I don't know if that's another issue.
A lot of them honk on their own. I mean, yeah. Literally, when we were congregated, how many
people
honk?
Do you know it's illegal for somebody to honk the horn for no reason other than safety reasons?
Yeah, but that's their
problem. Isn't that why they got a license?
Well, I know. But do you think that's in response to your sign, though?
A lot of tickets you could go write.
Yeah.
You could make a lot of money today.
Yeah. But do you think the sign may be taking some of that on, though, obviously. That's my point. Okay?
I also honk when I see a good bumper sticker.
I honk when I see a hot chick, dude.
You're in a violation when you do that.
It's not a violation, though. We have to get this clear, though. The Supreme Court's ruled over and over that honking in response to something of a political message is protected political speech.
Oh, they have,
huh? Established case law.
Well, you may know that. I can't argue with you on that one. But you know what? I'm just telling you that there is a state code, traffic code in Arizona, that's illegal for you to use your horn other than for emergency purposes.
Sure.
Okay? So I don't know what the Supreme Court said, but I'm not sure about that one. I can't argue.
I would totally agree.
At least I'm not violating
that. What's that?
And I'm
there. Well, nobody up here is going. That's not the issue. It's down there, you know. I don't want something to happen because, you know, if something were to happen as a response to somebody reacting to the sign, obviously, at that point, all of you guys become somewhat liable. Well, if we can show that it was in response to what's out here. And that's my concern. I don't want anything to happen out here, even though that's GPS's jurisdiction. We also, as a law enforcement officer, I also have a concern for what happens on any road.
Well, let's ask you, from what you're seeing right now, is there any way at this point that you can think of anything you can do to make this demonstration safer or more peaceful?
No.
You know one of these Oak Keeper cards?
What is this?
You ever heard of the Oak Keepers?
It's a group started by the military, brothers and sisters, and also police force. And it just basically says, a lot of different stuff about the Constitution to uphold it in case the government decides to enact any kind of tyrannical martial law. Such as when they did in Katrina, when they confiscated people's guns. And it's basically said you guys won't do that. And it's, like I said, started by your armed forces and also police officers across the country.
It's packed full of men and women, active duty, non-active duty, military, law enforcement.
It just says you'll abide the Constitution.
This is
what I give out to police officers, military, vets, Air Force, Navy, don't matter. They're just giving it down to you guys. It's an organization that, asks individuals to say, hey, if you come across police officers or, et cetera, armed forces, to show it to them, to say, ask them to upkeep your oath, to uphold the Constitution.
Have you guys ever had any these kind of protests before?
We don't do protests. It's a demonstration.
We utilize our First Amendment
right.
Some people protest somebody's demonstration.
We don't protest anything.
Somebody, okay.
I don't.
That's semantics.
Okay.
I'm not going to argue over protest or demonstration. You guys organize any kind of events like this before?
No. We kind of just long it. That was four of us last night. Together said, hey, you know what? 9/11 is tomorrow. Let's do something. Came up with the idea. So we decided to go ahead and get together and say, okay, let's implement that idea. That's all. It's an individual idea, someone's creative thought, and everybody comes together to make it possible.
Right.
That's all. Like I said, there's no hierarchy in this at all. So.
Well, you know what? What I would suggest to you guys, I can't order you to do anything at this point in the situation we're talking about here.
Right.
We have a community response bureau that deals with.
Alan and. Yeah, we know them very well.
I would suggest in the future to avoid any problem with whoever or whatever officers may or not respond to another demonstration like this, that you maybe work with those guys.
We can call them up.
You let them know, hey, we're thinking about doing this.
We should have just called them anyway, dude.
Especially where we're at this
Because
morning.
What they will do is...
Yeah, no shit.
All officers today have been very, very, helpful.
Except for at that deal.
We're not here to give anybody our time. We're not here to do our job.
I mean, you guys have been doing your job and actually not, asserting any, aggression like that. You guys are just coming and talking to us. So it's actually really cool to see that. So I just wanted to let you guys know. I appreciate you guys doing a good job.
Well, I have no reason to come up here and play
hardball. Well, you see stuff on video on YouTube.
I see that stuff, too.
That's the only reason why I'm saying thank you to all of you guys. So.
All right.
But like I say, I would highly recommend, because what happens if you notify that Community Response Bureau, Community Relations Bureau, actually, I'm using the wrong terminology. What they will do is they notify the bureau that the area of town where that's going to be affected. So we're aware, hey, this is what's happening.
So you don't even have to say you ain't coming out here.
Yeah. Plus, they can also advise you guys on how to do it properly without violating city or state ordinances. You know, cool. You say, hey, this is what we plan on doing. Well, you can't do that, but you can do this. They work with people. They work with groups all the time. Okay.
Yeah, we know them. We know them.
That's what I'm saying. Work with them. And it's going to make it easier for you guys, because we're going to know about it. They're going to notify the bureau out here that, hey, on Saturday, the group's going to be out here. This is what they're doing. We've already talked to them about it. Already okay with everything we're doing. We're legal. We got nothing to worry about. We don't have to come out here and go through the, you know, the loopholes here and try to figure out what we're doing. Okay? Makes it easier for you guys. It makes it easier for us. Denny City property. Is that the ones? It's the same one. I believe it has to do with putting signs on light poles and telephone poles and all that kind of stuff. So, we'll wait just a few minutes. We're going to go over anyway.
So you do have to hold it against there, you can't attach it, right?
Well, it's like I told you earlier, there is a city code that very clearly says you cannot attach any signs or of any sort to city property.
Yeah, tell you what, sit on.
Yeah, you know what? Let's go ahead. I'm still waiting for my boss to call me back, but the city code was just verified. It's very clear about not attaching any signs to city property. Okay? So
that would be zip tie. You can actually push it up, right?
You can hold it up.
If you want to hold it, that's
you
fine.
Hold it, yeah.
We were doing it before. I just got
Yeah. So let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and attach it.
Oh, is that you guys just got that call right now?
Well, no, we've checked the city code.
Okay.
We
don't
have the city code that attached
it. Okay. Who's got a knife? Peter, you got a knife?
That's not attached, is it? Oh, okay. Is that attached?
We're good now, right?